Hey, this is Nick Hawks with DePIN State. I got Raullen Chai, co-founder of IoTeX, on with us. Raullen, thanks so much for coming on.
Thanks for having me. Glad to be here.
Yeah, super excited to have you here. So IoTeX is pretty well known for helping a lot of other projects get their project onto the blockchain and into kind of Web3 space. You've got some pretty exciting news around DevNet. Do you want to talk me through what's going on there?
Yeah, definitely. Like, we have a new decentralized protocol. Actually, we just launched DevNet on Tuesday, June 6th, which is very exciting, actually. So we're here to helping like a different DePIN projects to like, you know, kind of sprout and grow. The web streaming specifically actually addresses three problems like we saw a lot of DePIN builders or entrepreneurs actually facing. The first one is hardware headache. And the second one is, you know, how to practice Cody's law principle, which is, sounds very familiar in the, to all the Web3 guys, but how to practice this one in the real world or Web2 world. Yep. And the last one is, you know, how can we help them to go to market faster? Yeah, I can dive down into some of them if we want to.
Yeah, please. Yeah, walk me through kind of what you're thinking on each of them.
Definitely. I think the first one is hardware headache. Everybody knows hardware is hard. And unless you are very well-funded projects, you usually don't have the, you know, time, resources, as well as people to actually work on the specific hardware need for your kind of DePIN ideas. Like the thinking we have is trying to have like a common SDK, so you can use some, even some common hardwares, you know, to start actually to start your DePIN project very easily, right? So unless you hit like a 100K devices, you don't have to do your specific hardware. So that basically lowers the tech barrier for a lot of people to get started in the DePIN space. Yeah. So that is what I mean by hardware headache.
Nice. And I guess that leads us to a question. We have a question on every show. This one's a GeoNet question. And GeoNet is a supporter of the show. If you want to do what they're doing and buy one of their pieces of hardware, you can check out the link in the description. And that really is, Raullen, how does someone kind of new to this get into DePIN? Like, where would you start them off, especially in the IoTeX world?
Yeah. So that's the second one I was going to talk about, right? So code is law, which is the kind of truth in the Web3 world. So that's why, like, you trust a smart contract to put your money to produce some yield, for example. But yep. How do we practice this one in the real world, right? Especially you have devices, like blockchain devices, they don't know each other. They don't know what to do with each other. Right. So that's why we have this kind of web stream as a middle guy, decentralized middleware, sitting between the blockchain and device, trying to, you know, funnel in all the device telemetrics, data, events, whatever, and produce, you know, based on your customized compute logic to produce concise proof to the blockchain, says, oh, your device network is doing a great job, so give those guys 10 tokens, right? Very simple example. So this is how we help, you know, people to kind of enforce this Cody's law idea. Of course, we have a very nice front end, which we call the WebStream Studio. So you don't have to, you know, type all the commands, which is tedious, you know, to talk with the protocol itself. But we have very nice interface for developers, builders, even non-tech builders to actually start to use WebStream to start their project.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. So the hardware is hard. You guys are helping solve that part. You've got this piece where you're basically kind of connecting the blockchain to the real world. And you guys have a long history in that. You guys called it Machine Fi before anyone called it DePIN. We've all settled on DePIN now, but it's pretty cool to see how long you guys have been doing this. What's the third piece that you guys are talking
about? Yeah, third piece is some like a go-to-market, right? So we saw a lot of DePIN builders because, you know, DePIN is like has a huge tech stack. If you're a guy actually master all this huge tech stack, usually you're not the guy who's doing go-to-market. Right. Okay. That's kind of like a dilemma we saw for a lot of DePIN projects. That's why we actually offer some like out-of-box services and products and also marketing packages for product to to actually like a protocols to go to market rather fast. So one of the products actually we're working with a lot of, you know, even GeoDNet, we're working with them in terms of integration is called Trusted Metrics, right? So the idea is pretty simple. So we will have like a unified dashboard for all the DePIN project. We, you know, supply. So they supply like a trusted metrics or data to this kind of product. And we kind of offer this or visualize this in a way together with some third party, like a visualization partners as well to try to shout out to the world. Okay. So DePIN's growth is definitely like a very unique and a strong area. And we're seeing a lot of interesting project grow. So this is one concrete product. Yeah, on the side, of course, we also gave them some like exposure on the marketing side as well.
Sure. Sure. Now, that's all the Web3 stuff, and you guys are really good at that. There's kind of a deep technical expertise over at IoTeX, and that's evident every time I talk to anyone on the team. But you guys are also known for being in the actual real world. You've had a couple of these real world events. I guess the question that I always like to ask, because I like to see people, is when is the next IoTeX event where folks can come and meet you and the rest of the team and kind of see what's going on with all the different projects?
Love that question. So actually, I was in a meeting, internal meeting, talking about this one with our guys. So we're hosting next one in the East City in Paris, which is July 16, actually. So we're going to host like a big side event over there in Paris. Join us.
Heck yeah, that sounds fun. We'll see if we can get on a plane and get over there. Awesome. Well, if you're watching the show, you know that these things are short and sweet. I think that's a ton of great information, Raullen. Is there anyone or anywhere you want people to go to check out more on IoTeX kind of right now?
Yeah, definitely. Like if you want to take a look at this new shining product, it's called the WebStream, W3bstream.com. Yep. Go there. So you click like get started. You can see like this product I'm talking about. Give it a try.
All right. We'll drop a link down in the description so you can check it out. If you haven't already, make sure you like and subscribe and make sure that you see when we drop new shows and get great guests like Raullen on the show. Raullen, thanks so much for coming on today.
All right. Thank you so much, guys. Have a good one.